good, BHR TV? Back again with another video, and today we have Vince Staples with, is it called just Vince Staples? Okay, with Vince Staples. Okay, this is gonna be kind of like a first listen-ish to me, because I never really cared to ever listen to his music. I don't know about y'all. Have y'all ever cared to get into Vince Staples music or try to listen to it? Nah, not really. Yeah, so I honestly don't know what to expect. All I know about Vince Staples is people at some point cancel him for dissing X or some shit at the BET Awards or whatever happened, like, what was that, forever ago? But, yeah, how many tracks we got is, there's only 10 tracks and how long is it? 22 minutes. So it's kind of a short album, or is it a mixtape? Will y'all let us know? I don't know. This is going to assume album. Okay. So, yeah, we only got one feature on here. Like you said, don't really know what to expect. So we're just going to hop into this and give y'all our thoughts at the end. Are you with that? Okay.
Yeah. 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 My way, left me with the either or. I feel these wounds and fill my bank. Blue strips, are you with that? I won't get back. I'm going up out and crack. Are you with that?
Yeah, that was nice.
That was cool.
Yeah, that was really nice. It gives me like Dreamville, like kind of vibes production wise, and just how he was flowing on that. That makes sense.
And he kind of switched his flow and like, you know,
yeah. Wow,
that's like some like late night car ride type.
Most definitely. Windows down if it was just right outside. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a great song. That was a great intro. I'm really looking forward to what else we got going on here.
Law of Averages.
What's it called?
Law of Averages.
Law of Averages. Okay. Wow, really mellow production. First two tracks.
Fuck a bitch, I don't trust no bitch with my government. Fuck a friend, I don't get that nigga gone right.
Wasn't he on a song on Dream?
Yeah, he was on there.
I forgot. Yeah, he was on there. I referenced Dreamville. I just now remember that he was on there. I don't think I listened to that song really.
Does this project have any features?
There's one feature.
Fouché?
Yeah, Fouché or whoever that is.
That I ever known, ask me for a loan, leave me alone, 40 post alone. Dairy have, Loki Sheriff, how you average. Birkin bag, Chloe bag, you got baggage.
So he's saying the law of averages, he's saying he's like, you don't give your money to a bad bitch. That's what kind of what he's saying, and then. Or what are you gonna say?
No.
Okay.
It sounded like, I don't know if he was calling the bad bitch average. I think that's what I heard.
Oh.
I don't remember.
Yeah, let me keep listening.
Niggas falling out and screaming like they Baptist. Only love it if I'm gonna catch a case. No, I ain't called up when I call my 38. Kiss your baby. I don't trust no bitch with my girl.
Ooh, was that a transition?
Yeah, I think it was.
I think it was a transition. We might have to go back and check that out. But that was a really good song. I really like that.
Yeah, that was cool.
It's a top song whenever you click on his name.
Yeah.
That
on
one
Spotify.
Is?
Spotify.
Oh, wow. Okay. Damn.
But his top song is North North.
Ah.
Because that is like the most streams.
Okay. I like how he was talking about her coming with baggage and was talking about the different type of expensive ass bags and shit.
Something about these female rappers and all these breaking bags and shit.
Yeah,
I feel like he was just saying, like, a lot of these girls who classify themselves as a bad bitch is not an average. It's because it's all of them doing it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it ain't nothing special about it.
Yeah, exactly. Every female think they're a bad bitch or whatever.
Okay.
So, that was a good song. I really like that. Let's see if that was a transition. Yeah. Would that count as a transition? Features can't break, you know, features can't fuck up shit. Wow.
They are short.
Yeah. They got a lot going on though, the production and his voice and the samples and shit. Wow, that was a great track too. He's so far 3 for 3 for me.
That was a solid track.
Yeah, that might be my favorite one.
Yeah, these have gotten better.
Yeah, most definitely. Let's see what we got here with The Shining.
The Shining.
It's not what you think. I could be going to blink. I don't wanna leave. We dying, broken lips, broken hearts. Just fucking bitch. That's when I'm a
movie. Ooh, I knew that was come back in. I just wanted to know what he said there. I couldn't hear it over the fucking bass. If she plastic, I can't give her something.
She attractive, but she plastic. I can't give her that shit. Oh. She the baddest out here doing that. But,
okay. Yeah, I felt that. But 90% of their females are fucking plastic nowadays. Mm-hmm. Like, dead ass. This is crazy.
That's hard.
Yeah, that was hard. I wasn't expecting this, honestly, going to Vince Staples. For some reason, when I think Vince Staples, I think of a more of aggressive artist.
Yeah, I was thinking kind of louder.
Yeah, like a little louder. I don't know. I think I've heard maybe a song from him before that was more aggressive or something that I'm thinking of. For y'all fans, y'all probably know.
Well, when he was on Revenge of the Dreamers, a lot of his shit was more like, it had more, like, aggression? I'm not gonna say emotion, but like, he was definitely a little more hype.
Yeah.
But like this, I feel like this is more appealing.
Yeah, most definitely. Shit, I mean, it's been taking me by surprise for sure.
Yeah.
Shit, let's get into the next one. It's called
Taking Trips.
Taking Trips.
This number 5.
This number 5.
Don't come for me and let's go find me what you see.
Yeah, but I was supposed to go straight home from school.
But
he's couldn't wait
for yeah, trippy. Yeah.
Wait, so what did he do? Because he was talking about something at the school and he wanted to please, he would say he wanted to do it, show the boys or something. I don't know. I didn't understand. Y'all let us know what the message was in that one.
It was an interlude between the second verse and the chorus saying, when you play rope with us, we're supposed to go straight home from school.
Yeah.
I just couldn't refuse. I knew I was doing the wrong thing, but I guess it was more important to be accepted by the guys than anything else.
Yeah. Huh. Shaking my head. It's not that important, guys, to, you know, because when you get out, when you freaking graduate high school, college, or whatever, or more for high school people, it's not, bruh. Life is so much different when you get out into the real world.
Dude,
do not try to impress people.
It's depressing.
It's depressing as fuck.
Look, bro, I miss high school.
Man, I do too. I mean, a lot. We was all like, we ready to graduate. And now it's like, dang.
It's like that first little bit between high school and like the people who went to college and shit. Like, uh-huh. It was cool.
That was before COVID. That was right before. I mean, right.
To the people who didn't go to college, like straight out of high school, bro. Yeah. They found like they was working, like working their ass off, crazy ass hours.
Man. Yeah, I just don't know. And cost of living's going up. Like, everything is going up right now. It's just crazy.
You can't get apartments because they don't make enough.
Man.
They making a lot down here. But
shit, I just signed a lease, goddamn it. I'm pretty happy. By fucking August 20th, we will have a new spot. Hopefully, we will have a new spot.
The apple in the tree.
Okay, the apple in the tree. Or is it just me?
It says this is an audio clip of his mom describing lying on the stand to defend his father, and furthermore seeking out to the person whom Vincent's father, who was convicted for attempting to murder.
Damn.
The title is referential to the adage, "The apple doesn't fall far from the tree." Loyalty illustrated is the same as Vince shows towards his own family and the fellow gang members.
Damn.
Where in the past he has ramped about acting out and resorting quickly to violence when played with.
Yeah. Wow, that's crazy. So his father fucking was in court for fucking murder and shit?
For attempted murder.
Attempted murder. Okay, I missed the whole attempt. Yeah. Wow. He got a good woman in. Shit, boy, we're just gonna go into the next one now. Take me home.
I've heard a few of his songs.
Yeah.
Dame Dolla. He can actually like rap, bro.
I believe it. He can rap. I hear that all the time. I just never really try to get into his shit. Might have to. But this has been a great track so far. It's been one of my favorites.
Oh yeah.
I don't know if it's smooth.
Bro.
It's smooth as fuck.
Yeah, this smooth as fuck.
Yeah. Like we said, that was probably one of my favorite tracks. I really liked the production on that one. The way he was just surfing on that beat. Like, that was amazing. I would have to go back and listen to it for the content more. But the vibe for sure was amazing on that. Shit, y'all got anything else to say?
Very chill.
Yeah, for sure.
So far, I'm loving this little project.
Yeah, I am too. I'm glad that we... freaking hitting this one. Damn. Tripping with your whip spray. Jumping with my bitch stay. So what's up with it? Tell me if it's up. Best stay with it. No, I can't play with it. This sound like a movie song. Like, it's not to be in a movie.
He actually was in this one animated movie that I saw on Netflix.
Yeah, recently?
Not like recently, but like a couple years ago.
Yeah.
It just came out like 2019.
Uh-huh.
I forgot what it's called, but it's on Netflix.
Yeah.
Shit is good as hell.
Yeah, I could really hear this on like a, I was seeing like, I was really seeing this could be in a movie or some shit. But I don't know. That's just what I'm getting from it. That was a cool track. It's one of my least favorites out of all of them.
Yeah.
But it was a solid track nonetheless.
Yeah.
It was still good.
Yeah. It still ain't been a bad song yet.
Not at all. Yeah, we're going to the next one, Lakewood Mall. I mean, where we at?
Police thoroughly searched the car.
Who's that?
Oh, God, nigga, got cracked without the cap. And I never even knew I got.
Mike Tyson?
It just says Tyson.
Tyson? Yeah.
I don't know if it's Mike
Tyson.
Yeah.
What was he saying?
He's not even like. I think it's just like a tape. Or
a tape playing?
Or,
yeah. Probably.
Yeah, it's not even like a whole verse.
Okay.
It's just the interlude.
Okay.
That's what it is. It's an interlude. All
right. But yeah, we got one more track.
Come get a body, 30 deep on copy. Police on
copy.
It's been a minute since I've been up in the trenches. Soft and cherry, you can see rich cuz. Flip cuz, cuz they miss cuz. I ain't got it.
Yeah, that's his
heart. Focorona, I was at Ramona with the mask.
What he say? Snitching niggas even got the water tap.
Oh yeah, I heard that, but I didn't hear what he said. I heard something about tap. Yeah, that's hard.
Yeah, the water tap. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Damn. Yeah, that's hard. Okay. Yeah, that's hard. Damn. He really gave me Cordae vibes. Damn, that was a great project. So that was Vince Staples with Vince Staples.
It was short and sweet.
Yeah, yeah. It was definitely. Was not too long. It was not extremely short. Some tracks, like we said, maybe could have had some features on it. But you know, features can also break a song, and these really haven't had no miss. Damn.
Shit.
Yeah, that was a good ass album.
It surprised me.
Yeah, it surprised me too. I'm definitely gonna have to look back. I'm gonna have to go back and listen to some of his other music too. See if it's kind of like this or not. But y'all let us know what y'all favorite tracks are, what y'all think about it. The one feature on here did good too.
Yeah.
What was the name?
Touché.
I like that because that track was beautiful. That was a great track.
Mm-hmm.
shit. damn. I don't even know what else to say. I guess, y'all got anything to say?
That was a pretty good track.
I
mean, pretty good album.
Yeah.
Mixtape, whatever.
It's pretty short.
I feel like it's a mixtape.
It could be. I mean, the way it's put together, I don't know. It sounds like an album. It got like an album sound to it, no lie.
Hey, I mean, that's a good thing. Even if it is a mixtape,
bro. Yeah. He really has a music, like a ear for music.
Yeah.
Yeah, I never knew that about Vince Staples until now. So it's really cool to hear that. And like we said, Dreamville already knew that, I guess. So they had him on there. Had him doing his thing. See what happens from here. I mean, I don't think his career is going to get too much bigger than it already is. I mean, than what it is right now.
Yeah, I mean, he's still popular.
Yeah, he's still popular, but I don't think his fan base will ever go crazy.
He ain't going to be on the mainstream.
Nah, I don't think. That would be cool. You don't think so? I mean, too many artists are getting mainstream, though.
Some artists, I don't want them to get to reach that mainstream.
Yeah, that's how I felt about a lot of our like Sada Baby and shit. When that nigga went mainstream, I was like, damn, you hear fucking Activated on the radio every day, and that shit got annoying as hell. But yeah, like we said, it was a solid project. Y'all let us know what y'all think about it. Like, comment, subscribe, and yeah, we're out.